ஹாய், ஹலோ, வணக்கம் அண்ட் வெல்கம் டு எட் அனதர் எபிசோட் ஆன் லிட்டில் ஸ்லா யூடியூப் சேனல். இன் திஸ் வீடியோ வி ஆர் கோயிங் டு சி அபவுட் அனதர் இன்ட்ரெஸ்டிங் லூட் ரன்னர் யூட்டிலிட்டி ஃபங்க்ஷன் விச் இஸ் தி எல்ஆர் அண்டர் ஸ்கோர் வேல் அண்டர் ஸ்கோர் ஸ்ட்ரிங். So this function returns the input string after evaluating any embedded parameters. And if the string argument contains only a parameter, the function returns the current value of the parameter. And that is the function of this LR eval string. So this LR eval string can be used in lot many different ways, and we will see them how to do it in this entire video. So before we move on to this video, this is me, your Vasant Shanmugam. I request you all to subscribe to our channel if you have not subscribed yet. Like, comment your questions and feedbacks in the comment section and share the video with your friends. So let's now see what this LR eval string does. So this returns the string argument after evaluating any embedded parameters it has. And this LR eval string function returns the input string after evaluating any embedded parameters. And if the string argument contains only a parameter, the function returns the current value of the parameter. And there is one more thing which is about this LR eval string, is that it allocates memory internally. And this memory is automatically freed at the end of each iteration. So when we use this to manipulate any values, the memory that is being used by this LR eval string is automatically freed at the end of each iteration. And even we can use LR underscore eval underscore string underscore ext to manually free the memory in each iteration with LR eval string underscore ext underscore free. But however, using a free statement in the custom code may result in memory corruption. So it is always safe to best to use the LR underscore eval underscore string. While returning the values, the function returns the value of the specified string or null on error. And all the arguments can be parameterized using standard parameterization. So let's now see with example of how to use this LR eval string. So here we have this LR eval string, and before that let's bring a load runner utility function which is LR save underscore int, where we have the value 0 and we are saving it in a value which is search count. And then we have a function which is if the value is a to I, which is to integer, where we have our LR eval string. And then we bring in the condition where the search count, where if the search count is equal to 0, the LR output message is going to be is 0. Since the value is 0, so we are giving it as 0. So now we bring the value as LR eval string. As search count, where we display the value here. So what we did here is we saved an integer in the value search count, and we did an evaluation, that is, we are trying to evaluate the embedded parameter here, which is the search count. So we are checking whether the value is equal to zero, and if the message, and if the value is zero, automatically we display that in the message. So let's try that here. So here we can see, since the value is zero, so automatically we could get that in the result. So we'll try one more example where, see here, since the value is zero, we have displayed that in the as zero. And what if the value is not zero? So let's try that option as well. And here we will give the number as 50. So the search count value is now 50. And here, in the previous example, we have given the LR eval string is equal to zero, and here let's make it to not equals to zero. And if it is not equal to zero, we will have to change the function, which is not equal to zero, and then we display the search count. So what again we do here is, the LR eval string function returns the input string after evaluating the embedded parameter, or after evaluating the parameter or the value inside it, and then based on that it returns the current value. So let's try it one more again. And here we can see, in the first example we could see the value was zero, so it was mentioned as zero, and in the second example it was not equal to zero, so automatically the value has been displayed as not equal to zero. So this is how the eval string works. So what does this eval string does is, this evaluates a parameter, and after evaluating the parameter, it replaces the parameter with its current value. So that is what the eval string does. So not with only integers, it also works with strings. So let's try a string here. So let's save the string in here. So what is going to be the string? So the string is an URL, which is google.com, and we will serve the value in the URL here. And the next thing is, we are going to output the message with evaluating it. So how are we going to evaluate it? So since it's a string, we will declare it here. We'll display it here. Then let's evaluate the string, which is inside the URL. So now we have the values which we have displayed inside the URL. So we have saved the string initially with the string under the string URL, and now we are evaluating the string. So what are we doing now is, we are evaluating the embedded value, and we are going to display that. So in each and every step, what are we doing is, in the step 3, that is in the action line number 3 or 4, so what are we doing is, we are saving the parameter in the URL, and the next step is, we are doing a parameter substitution, and then we are giving it as an output message. So let's run and see. So initially we saw that with an integer, so we were able to evaluate and display that as an integer, and now we are doing it for the string. So this LR eval string is able to manipulate both the integer and the string. So with that, we come to an end, and this is how we can use the LR eval string. So we can save any value, we can evaluate it, we can embed, we can evaluate the embedded value, and we can save it, and we can use it in the load runner as part of the utility function using the LR eval string. I think this video would have been very useful to you. Please do subscribe our channel for more informative and interesting videos. Until we meet you in another interesting video, it's bye-bye from Asan Shanmugam and Little Slaw.